In this how-to video, we'll cover the DIY basic install and maintenance of our IronHorse Cast Iron Helical Gearboxes. Now, before we get started, let's discuss safety. Prior to working on any mechanical or electrical device, please make sure you're wearing proper PPE. To minimize the risk of potential safety problems, you should follow all applicable local and national codes that regulate the installation, maintenance, and operation of your equipment. Studies state that helical gearboxes are the most commonly used gear in transmissions. Helical gearboxes offer less vibration, wear, noise, and tend to have a longer life. If you're trying to select the proper gearbox for your application, please refer to our IronHorse gearbox selection video, the selection guide, or call our free award-winning technical support. Now, these can all be found on our website at AutomationDirect.com. In the following discussions, I refer to this user manual. Now, you can find this manual on our website at AutomationDirect.com. Prior to installation, we need to decide how will the gearbox be mounted in order to determine the placement of the vent plug and what hardware and accessories will be required for proper mounting. Now, first, we inspect the gearbox for any damage that may have occurred during shipment. Clean the gearbox if needed, now and during maintenance. Do not allow chemicals on the seals, as they can cause seals to deteriorate and leak. Our cast iron helical models include a vent plug that may be plastic like this one, or brass like this one. The vent plug is included with our helical gearboxes and is attached during shipment. Depending on the gearbox mounting orientation, we may need to move where the vent plug is installed. All IronHorse helical gearboxes have 6 filler oil gauge drain plug locations. Now, these plugs are located in different locations depending on the actual box size selected. The vent plug should be installed in the filler position as specified in the user manual. The plug in the oil gauge location should be removed while filling with oil. Oil has reached the proper level in the gearbox when it starts to drip out of the gauge port. After filling, plug the gauge port and install the vent plug in the filler port. If your vent plug is plastic, remove the red pin from the plug. This red device closes the breathing hole so oil does not leak out during shipping. The brass plug only needs to be installed and is ready to go. Mounting instructions can be found in the user manual on this chart. The helical gearbox can be placed in any of 5 install positions. M2 mounting position, where the gearbox output shaft is vertical pointing down, is not permitted. This same chart informs the user where the filler, oil gauge, and drain plug should be located depending on mounting orientation. All IronHorse helical gearboxes are tested and filled with lubricant prior to shipping. Oil may need to be added or partially drained depending upon your mounting orientation. Make sure you don't add too much oil because it'll cause overheating and cause seals to leak, while too little oil will result in gear failure. To ensure the proper amount of oil, mount the gearbox, determine the vent plug, gauge, and drain plug locations, and fill or drain the oil to the proper amount recommended in the user manual. It is very important to use the proper lubricant when adding or changing the oil. Recommended oil types and brands are specified in the user manual. These IronHorse helical gearboxes do not require a run-in procedure. However, the oil should be changed after the first 300 hours of operation and then every 2,500 hours or every 6 months, whichever comes first. It is recommended to use an anti-seize compound on hollow output shafts. Now, once the gearbox is installed and tested, the gearbox temperatures should be monitored during initial operation. If the temperature exceeds 80 degrees Celsius, that's 176 degrees Fahrenheit, check for overloads, high ambient temperatures, and proper venting. Now, you can find the specs for these IronHorse helical gearboxes on our website at AutomationDirect.com. And don't forget, we sell worm gearboxes, motors, motor controls, and more. And if you need any help with selecting a gearbox or have questions, please contact Automation Direct's free award-winning technical support team during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post questions directed at Automation Direct's technical support staff there. They do not monitor the forums on a regular basis. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.